getting the stairs done, the next thing I wanted to tackle was the bedroom window. There was a whole load of water which was always leaking in, the windowsill needed sanding, there was black mould around it, the plaster was chipping, and it just needed to be fixed. So far, the heat gun has easily been the most used piece of equipment apart from the sander in the house. It's got a few different heads and I like to use an art spatula. I actually hate the scraper that it comes with. I found it to be completely useless. So I like heating up the paint first and then taking the spatula. And also because it's an art spatula, I can just be a little bit more accurate with it than the weird paint stripping looking thing that arrived with it. I tried using it a few times and it was useless, so I got rid of that and just started using the spatula, and I haven't found a need to change that since. It's just been absolutely perfect for what I needed it for. So today's target was mainly just getting the windowsill done. I still need to fill in the bit along the edge of the ceiling. You can see that there's holes everywhere, and that's because we found out that the roof was leaking over the winter and it's severely damaged some of the walls, so I'm going to need to fill that in, but I can start doing that after day two. For day two, it was just finishing off the rest of the windowsill, starting to clean everything. The paint was all gone, so now I needed to get rid of the mold that was just everywhere. So I took some mold spray, pulled up all the silicone that was along the edge, which was just moldy and disgusting and needed to be removed, cleaned away all the mold. The mold had stained the plaster and the white paint, so there was only so much I could remove without actually painting over it. But once everything was clean, I filled in all the plaster that was chipped with polyfiller, waited for that to dry, sanded it down, and then just bit by bit started painting everywhere that had gone wrong and filling in all the cracks. And this is the part where I just completely lost track of the days. There were some days where I didn't have an entire morning which I could devote to this. I just had to do a few bits and pieces every so often. So this is now over the course of the last 3 to 4 months, just gradually chipping away. And on this bit, you can see where all that water is starting to get into the window. Every morning there would always be a puddle. And what I found out is that the windows aren't sealed on the outside, and I hadn't found this out yet, so it was something that I still needed to do, but I wanted to focus on the inside, get the silicone on the inside cleaned, the walls painted, and then I wanted to get the cracks along the ceiling filled in with polyfiller.
One
of the things I was happiest about and was so easy was getting a new lampshade. The old lampshade I made was awful, and this was such a quick, easy fix. I found it on Facebook Marketplace, which I was so happy about. And now we're going to move to, I think, a month later after I'd done this, I finally sealed the windows. And ever since then, I haven't had any problems with moisture coming in. I was so, so happy to finally do this. I just needed to get the enthusiasm to go up a ladder and actually do it. And then finally is all the sanding. I was hoping that I could spray the windowsill so that it would be completely wet and then sand it so that the dust wouldn't go everywhere. But eventually I realized that doing it by hand was going to take forever. So I thought, nope, we're just going to have to use the sander and we're just going to have to make a mess. And it's okay if we do this quickly and in one day, hopefully it's all going to be done and then I'll finally have a lovely window again. Once I've finished off the beam up there and sanded that, then I'm going to clean this whole room from top to bottom, brush down the walls, mop the floor, change the bed sheets, lift the mattress off the bed, dust under the bed, and just basically give the whole room a deep clean. As it is, the room is empty, shouldn't take any longer than an hour. And then after that, I'm going to be putting a kind of polish, but a kind of wood treatment, a homemade one, which is dirt easy to make. I've already got the recipe on my blog, so if you want to make that and you have a bit of olive oil and beeswax and a few essential oils around, you're golden. I'll put that on the wood because this windowsill is dry. I'm amazed it didn't catch on fire while I was sanding it. It's insanely dry. I might put some wood treatment on the beam above. I'm just going to see how the wood is once I've taken the paint off, and then we'll go from there. I hate sanding so much. Now that the floor was clean, I just needed to make sure that the dust on the sheets wasn't going to go everywhere, so I sprayed it with water and then carried on cleaning underneath the bed. Well, that's disgusting. Now that I was finally at the end of the project, it was just kind of loads of little details. I'd accidentally sanded away some of the paint on the walls when I was sanding the beam, so I wanted to paint over that. These are the curtain rails. I'd had to kind of adjust the end because the ends that I'd bought hadn't fit. So I cut them down, put them inside the pole, hot glued them, and then sprayed it. And then it was just little details all around the room. I needed to fill in some cracks, which had happened when I was sanding the windowsill. It had just shaken the plaster loose. Made sure that that was all blended down, painted over it, and then since I was already painting over various bits in the room, I figured I'd just paint over any marks that were also on the walls, which I guess is one of the benefits of having white paint. It doesn't really matter the brand. I've used three different brands in the past, and provided you don't have that massive difference between a warm white or a cool white, it's just not noticeable. It just all blends together. One of the things I wanted to do was paint the light fixing so that it just matched everything a bit better. And then after that, it was just details. It was just finishing it off to look exactly how I wanted. that's it, another project done. And as usual, if you like my videos and want to see more content, feel free to follow me on the mailing list. That way you get everything sent directly to your email, and I'll have a new video for you soon.